हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम फॉर टुडेज वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ गणित प्रावीण्य। लेट्स सॉल्व रिमेनिंग एग्जांपल्स फ्रॉम द एक्सरसाइज 20। एग्जांपल नंबर 17, फाइंड द अमाउंट ऑफ रुपीज 1500 इन 3 years एट 5% पर एनम। नाउ सी हियर इन दिस प्रॉब्लम वी हैव टू फाइंड द अमाउंट which has to be repaid after 3 years. Okay, so in this, what is principal, what is loan taken, that is principal rupees 1500, correct? Okay, now second, for how much period it is taken? For 3 years. The loan is taken for 3 years, and at what rate of interest, what is rate of interest for this loan? 5% per annum, that is 5 PCPA. Okay, and we have to find at the end how much, at the end of 3 years, how much amount we have to repay to the bank. Okay, so you know amount means what? The amount at the end of the period which we have to pay, that amount is what? This principal plus interest. Okay, so here principal we know, but interest we don't know. What will be the interest? That we have to calculate, right? So let's first calculate the interest, that is simple interest. And you know formula for the simple interest, P into N into R upon 100, correct? So P means principal is 1500 into n, n means 3 years, and r rate of interest is 5, correct? Upon 100. So let's do the calculations. Now in the numerator, see this 1500 in this, there are 2 zeros at the end, and in 100 also there are 2 zeros, so these 2 zeros will be cut for these 2 zeros, okay? Now, in the denominator there is 1. So, when denominator is 1, that means nothing. Okay, not need to write. Just multiply the numbers in the numerator. 5 threes are 15, and 15 multiplied by 15. What is 15 multiplied by 15? 15 15s are 225. So, this is the interest on 1500 rupees after 3 years. What will be the interest? 225 with the 5% rate. So amount which we have to pay, you know amount is calculated by adding principal and interest. Okay, so principal is rupees 1500 plus interest is 225, correct? So total what amount should be paid? Rupees 1500 plus 225. So the answer is 1725. Okay, next 18th one. See now 18th one example. The simple interest for 1 year at a certain rate on rupees 400 is rupees 22. See the sentence. Read the sentence carefully. Find out what is given. Okay? See, out of these four concepts, P, N, R, SI or amount, any three will be given. Okay? Any three will be given. Any three I am saying. All the time we don't have to find simple interest. Sometimes simple interest can be given, and out of these three any one we have to find. Okay, so I said read the sentence very carefully, pick out what is given. Okay, so in this problem, see the simple interest for 1 year at a certain rate on rupees 400 is 22. So here simple interest is given. Okay, let me complete the problem. Find the interest, the amount of rupees 500 in 2 years at the same interest, same rate of interest there should be. Okay, so now see, there are two part of this example, part 1 and part 2. What, why part 1 and part 2? Part 2 because in part 1 principal is given. Okay, principal is what? Rupees 400. N is given, number of years or period, time of period is given for 1 year, right? For 1 year. And see here, simple interest is given. That is that 22 is there, no? Rupees 22. It is what? Simple interest. See the sentence. The simple interest for 1 year at a certain rate on rupees 400 is rupees 22. That means rupees 22 is simple interest. Okay. So simple interest is rupees 22. And what we have to find? What is not given? That is rate of interest. They have given certain rate of interest. Certain means what? Unknown, right? Something. So it is not given, that means we have to find. And whatever rate of interest we will get in this part, with the same rate of interest, we have to solve this. Because see, they have what second part is telling, find the interest on the amount of rupees 500 in 2 years at the same rate of interest. Means whatever rate of interest we will get here in this part, using that rate of interest, we have to find your simple interest. Okay, let's find first. To find rate of interest, there is not separate formula. This only formula we are going to use, because as I told you, in this formula, SI, simple interest is there, principal is there, period is there, and rate of interest is there. So out of these four, any three will be given, and one we have to find. So accordingly, we have to move the formula. Swing the formula. Now see, basic formula is simple interest is equal to P into N into R upon 100. Okay, so first let's put the values on their places. SI, simple interest is given, so we'll write rupees 22 here, is equal to P. Is principal given? Yeah, rupees 400 into N given, 1 year, into R not given, so we will write R as it is, okay, upon 100. Okay, now let's do calculations. These two zeros will be cut for these two zeros. In the denominator remain 1, that means nothing. Here in the numerator remain 4 into 1 into R. So these two numbers we can multiply. See, rupees 22 is equal to 4 ones are 4, rupees 4 multiplied by R will be as it is, okay, and denominator 1 means not need to write. Now see, we have to find value of R, correct? So this rupees 4 we will bring on this side using transpose theorem, okay? So rupees 22, see, this rupees 4 is multiplied to R. When it will change its side, it will be divided. Rupees 4 is equal to R. So this rupees cancel. 22 divided by 4. Now see, 22 directly, it is not in table of 4. Okay, so see, 4 5s are 20. 2 0. Okay, what we can do here? We can put decimal point here and we can give 0 at the end. After the 2, we will get 20. Now 4 5s are 20. So the answer is 5.5. Okay, so 22 divided by 4 is 5.5. Let us write here. R is equal to what? 5.5. So rate of interest in the first part we got 5.5 PCPA. Okay. So using same rate of interest, using this only rate of interest, we have to solve second part. Okay, second part, and we have to find simple interest. So in the second part, what is principal? Rupees 500. Okay, n period of time, what is that? For 2 years. 2 years. R we have found in the first part, that we are going to use here, 5.5. And simple interest we have to find. So simple interest formula, we know that P into N into R upon 100, correct? So P is what? Rupees 500 into N is 2 into R is 5.5 upon 100. Let's do the calculations. These two zeros will be cut for these two zeros. In the denominator remain 1. Nothing, so just multiply the numbers in the numerator. 5 2s are 10 into 5.5. Rupees 10 into 5.5. So if you multiply 5.5 by 10, what will you get? 0 will come down, 1 5 is a 5. 1 5 is a 5. After decimal point, there is 1 digit. So here, rupees 55. Rupees 55 will be the interest. Got it? Understand? Sometimes, see, this rate of interest we have found in decimal. That can be given in mixed fraction also. 5 whole 2 by 4. The 2 under 2, 2 2s are 4. So it can be given 5 whole 1 by 2. Okay, but 5 whole 1 by 2 is same as 5.5. Understand? Pause this video, write this to example in your notebook. See your example number 19. Put your finger. Rahul borrowed from a money lender rupees 2400 at 7% rate. He also borrowed rupees 2000 from a bank at 12% per annum. What sum of money should he pay in repaying both the loans after 2 years? So there is one person whose name is Rahul. So he has taken or he has borrowed money from two persons or two institutes. One from a private money lender. Money lender means a person who give the loan. And another loan he has taken from the bank. Okay. So we will make here two parts. Loan taken from money lender and loan taken from bank. In both the cases, he has taken loan for 2 years, correct? Okay, so from money lender, what principal he has taken? What amount of loan he has taken? Rupees 2400. So your principal is rupees 2400. What is rate of what is period of time? 2 years. In both the cases, period of time is 2 years and here rate of interest is 7% per annum, okay? And in this case, from bank he has taken principal rupees 2000 for 2 years only and rate of interest is here 12% per annum, okay? What sum of money should he pay? Means together amount this amount in this and amount in this together, how much amount he has to pay in return, okay, after 2 years. So now see, first we will find amount in this case and then we will find amount in this case, okay? So see here, to find amount, you know, we first need to find interest, because amount means principal plus interest. Then when we will find interest, then only we will be able to find amount. So let's first find the interest. Simple interest is equal to P into N into R upon 100. So P we have rupees 2400 into N is 2 years into R is 7 upon 100. Okay. So these two zeros will be cut with these two zeros. 24 into 2 into 7. 7 is about 14. Okay, so 24 into 14 we will do. 14 fours are 56. Okay. 14 twos are 28. Correct. 28 plus 5. 33. 14 4 56, 6 came down, 5 carry, 14 to the 28 plus 3, 33, okay. So, rupees 336 is the interest. So, amount will be principal plus interest, that is, principal is rupees 2400 plus amount is rupees, sorry, interest is rupees 336. So 2400 plus 336, 0 plus 66, here 3, 7, so 2736. Okay, this is the amount in the first case. Let us find amount in the second case. Here also, to find amount, first we need to find simple interest using formula P into N into R upon 100. So here principal is rupees 2000, N is 2 year, and rate of interest is 12 upon 100. If these two zeros will cut for these two zeros, 20 into 2 into 12. Now 12 twos are 24, so 24 into 20. 0 will come down directly, 2 4s are 8, 2 2s are 4, 480. 480 is the interest. Okay? So amount will be P plus I. P is 2000 plus interest is rupees 480. So total amount he has to repay to the bank, 2480, okay. So in this case, to money lender he has to return 2736 and to bank he has to return 2480. So total amount which he has to repay is rupees 2736 plus rupees 2480. Let's do addition. 6 plus 0, 6, 3 plus 8, 11, 1 will be carried, 7 plus 4, 11 plus 1, 12, 1 will be carried, 216 is the total amount which he has to pay. Okay, pause this video and write this example in your notebook. See next, example number 20. Find the amount of rupees 665 in 5 years at 8% per annum. Principal is given rupees 665. For how many years? 5 years. And what is rate of interest? Rate of interest is 8% per annum. Annum means annual, 1 year. So to find amount, first we have to find simple interest, right? So simple interest is equal to P into N into R upon 100. So here P is rupees 665. See here in the principal there are not two zeros at the end. So this calculation is going to be little challenging. N is 5, R is 8, okay, and upon 100. When there are 0 at the end, it become easy for us to calculate. Now what to do here? First we multiply and then we divide by 100. Division by 100 is very easy. So first let's multiply. 8 5s are 40, correct? 8 5s are 40 into 665. So 665 into 40. 0. Directly write first. 4 5s are 20, 4 6s are 24 plus 2, 26, 4 6s are 24 plus 2, 26 again. So when we multiply these three numbers, we got answer 26,600 upon 100. See, we got two zeros at the end. Third two zeros, rupees 266 is the interest. So once we got interest, now we can find amount. Amount is equal to principal plus interest.
That is principal we have ₹665 plus interest is ₹266. So 5 plus 6, 11. 1 will be, 1 will come down, 1 will be carried. 6 plus 6, 12 and 1, 13. 6 plus 2, 8 and 1, 9. ₹931 is the amount which is to be repaid after 5 years. Okay? Now pause this video, write this both the examples in your notebook.
See example number 21st. Atul kept a deposit of ₹1250 in a bank at rate 11% for 2 years. Vikas kept a deposit of ₹1100 in HDFC for 2 years. HDFC is the name of bank, okay? HDFC for 2 years at rate of 12%. From which institution more interest will be obtained after 2 years and how much? Okay, so here also there are two cases, two parts. In first part, there is one person named Atul. He has taken loan from a bank. Okay, and in the second part, there is another person, Vikas, he has taken loan. So in both that cases, whose interest is more? Who has to give more interest to the bank? And what is difference between them? By how much it is more? That we have to find, okay? So let's see. First, Atul. Two parts you will make, Atul and here, Vika. Okay? So in the first case, what is principal? He has taken loan of ₹1250. Okay? ₹1250. For how many years? In both the cases, period of time is same, 2 years, okay? At the end, it is given 2 years. And here, rate of interest is 11% per annum, okay? And in this case, principal is ₹1100, and rate of interest is n is 2 years and rate of interest is 12% per annum. See here, rate of interest is more, here rate of interest is less. Can you decide from here whose interest will be more? No, because why? Here principal is 1100, here principal is 1250. Okay, so that cannot be decided here. So we need to calculate interest. See, let's calculate the interest. Simple interest is equal to P into N into R upon 100. That is P is ₹1250 into N is 2 into R is 11 upon 100. 10 you can cut. Okay. Now see. 11 2s are 22 into 125. 125 into 22. 22 5s are 110, correct? You should know table. 0 will come down, 2 will be carried. 22 2s are 44. 44 plus 11, 55. 5 will come down, 5 will be carried. 22 1s are 22 plus 5, 27. So 2750 upon 10. Okay, multiplication of this 3 number is 2750 upon 10. So here see this 1010 cut. So remainder denominator became 1, that means not negative. Parity 275. So in this first case, the interest is 275. Okay. Now in the second case, what is interest? Let's find. Simple interest is equal to P into N into R upon 100. So principal is ₹1100 into 2 into 12 upon 100. These 2 zeros will be cut with these 2 zeros. 12 2s are 24 into 11. 24 into 11.
11 4 are 44, 4 carried, 11 2 are 22 plus 4, 26 rupees 264.
So whose interest is more? Atul's. Okay, Atul has to give more interest.
So in this, rupees 275 is greater than rupees 264.
By how much? By how much it is greater? Means what is difference in both? 64 here and 75. So if we subtract 275
and 264, we will get 111. So Atul has to pay rupees 11 more than the rupees 11 more as an interest so rupees 11 more interest than Vikas.
Okay, rupees 11 difference between their interest is rupees 11. Okay, so today in this lecture we have learned these 5 examples. If you have any doubt in these 5 examples, you can ask me during the doubt session. Remaining 3 examples, then the ma'am will teach you. Okay, so if you have any doubt in this whole lesson, ask me on these examples. Based on these examples, the test will be conducted at 2:30 p.m. Okay, so be ready for the test. Thank you and have a nice day.